are using computer-aided manufacturing. So mainly two purposes: to increase the efficiency of the manufacturing and to reduce the cost. Yes, already our best example is Nano car. So the minimum price they are selling the cars. Okay, but it has to work properly. Quality and the cost, both the things are very important in manufacturing. Next slide. So if you are seeing computer-aided manufacturing, so these things are very important. So first one, so before this computer-aided design, first one. Second one, computer-aided manufacturing, then computer-aided engineering, then computer-aided process planning, then simulator of process and the system. Okay. So here in older days, without computers, manually we did all the work. So nowadays, from the design into the marketing, so all the things we are using is what? Is computers. So here, first one is design. Okay. So then only we are going for the manufacturing. Yes, in R&D department, the design is the first thing. So after designing only, you will go for the manufacturing. Okay, so next one. So manufacturing systems. So here, so manufacturing means what? So what is the difference between manufacturing and production? Tell me the answers. So, the vast number of pieces if you are producing means that is coming under manufacturing. For example, the mass productions are coming under manufacturing. Very few numbers if you are producing means that is coming under production. Okay. The next one. So here, computer integrated manufacturing. So from the beginning, from the design into the marketing. So all the things from design and then what? Process planning, then production planning, and then inventory control, then the marketing. So all the things is integrated in manufacturing. Okay, so by using the computer, so that is coming in the computer integrated manufacturing. We are integrating all the things. Next one. So this is the schematic representation for C. So initially, what we are doing? So already we studied. So manufacturing planning is the first, then manufacturing control. So these two things are very important. So here, by using engineering concepts, we are planning by using the softwares and the schedules and making layouts, we can plan. Then you have to execute that. So execute it by the scheduling. So and then you have to control. So whether it reaches the standard or not, or reference or not, that is controlled by. So from the planning to control, all the things are done by using the computers. So that is why this computer, the computer integrated manufacturing. We are integrating all the units, because if you are considering one company means, in that company many departments are there. For example, R&D department, then process planning department, then production department, then quality control department, okay, then marketing, then the inventory control. Okay, so many departments are there, so all the departments are integrated by using the computers. So one main unit will be there, so in that we can get all the data. So one main server will be there. In that server, for example, so CEO is there, means he will have one computer. In that computer he can see all the things. So how they are planning, so what the current situation in their company, and how they are producing the product. So everything they can see. CEO means who is the owner of the company. Okay, so you can see at any time. The next one. So this is the benefits of computer integrated manufacturing. So by using computer, what are the benefits are there? So we can increase the quality of the product. Okay, so we can reduce the time. Then cost also we can reduce. Okay, so these are all the benefits of the computer integrated manufacturing. So this is like, so computer aided design. So here is coming first. Okay, so in SIM, the first thing is design. So one time we discussed about CAD. So in older days we have used the manually we designed all the components. Nowadays we are using the computers. Okay. So by using this, if we are making by manually means, so in that same paper we cannot modify the design. But in computer, once you made a diagram and you are saving in the computer means, so in future suppose if you want to modify that same component means, you can retrieve from the computer. But in manual thing it is not possible. Okay, so in paper. But when you are using computer, you can store the components, the designed components you can store into the computer, and anytime you can retrieve from the computer. That is the main advantage. So anytime you can check it and you can modify the diagram. So design, analysis and optimization. So here, so after the design, analysis is very very important. Okay. So whether whatever component we design, whether it is suitable or not. Because any component we can design, but it is suitable with the other component, that is very important. For example, that cantilever beam. So in that beam, if you are applying the load means, it will show you. So where the more load will act. For example, this bench you are designing and you are analyzing means where the maximum load will take place, at the center point or at the end point. So in a bench, we can consider as the fixed beam. Okay, so if you are sitting in this bench means at the center only all the loads will act. So what we have to do? So in center point, additionally we can fix some more rods. Okay, so yes, at the center point the more load is acting, that bending will be maximum at the center of the fixed beam. So that kind of analysis we can do. So we have to focus more on that particular point. So designing is very easy. So any component we can design. But after the design, we have to analyze that. Okay, so where the maximum stress will take place. So in that place, we have to concentrate more. Designing, we have to get approval from the higher officials. So after getting the approval, it will go to the manufacturing system. So in this system, we are using the computer. Not only computers, the electrical devices and the electronics devices and the mechanisms. So all the things we are considering for manufacturing. For example, if you are considering CNC milling machine or CNC lathe machine, means how it is operating, you are feeding the input by programs, right? Because the machine can read only the digital signals. So you are giving input by the keypad. It might be the analytical keyboard or the touch screen. So whatever it may be, you can feed the programs by G codes and M codes. Okay, so that is in analytical form. So when you are feeding that programs into the machine, is converted into the digital signals. It is like a binary, so 0, 1. So you are able to read that signals. Okay. Then that electrical components. So motors are the actuators. So electrical components like motors. Then many sensors we are using in the